In this problem, we're told the midpoint of the segment AB is point M with coordinates negative 2, 2. And if A, one of the endpoints of the segment, has coordinates negative 5, 7, we want to find the coordinates of the other endpoint, or the coordinates of point B. Let's take a look at a graph of the given information. First, if we were given the two endpoints of the segment and asked to find the midpoint, then we would just sub the coordinates of the two endpoints into our midpoint formula given here to find the midpoint. But this problem is different because we're given the midpoint, or this point here, as well as the coordinates of one of the endpoints, or this point here, and we're asked to find the other endpoint of the segment. And since we don't know the coordinates of point B or the other endpoint, let's go ahead and use x sub 2 comma y sub 2 for the coordinates of this point. So to set this problem up, we'll use point A and point B in the midpoint formula, and then set that equal to the midpoint, which we know has coordinates negative 2, 2. So again, our two endpoints are point A, which we know has coordinates negative 5, 7, and point B, which we don't know, so we'll go ahead and use x sub 2 comma y sub 2 for the coordinates of the two endpoints. And again, keeping in mind we know the midpoint, or point M, has coordinates negative 2, 2. So now we'll go ahead and use the midpoint formula using point A and point B. So we would have x sub 1 plus x sub 2 divided by 2, or in this case, negative 5 plus x sub 2 divided by 2, comma, then the y coordinate would be y sub 1 plus y sub 2 divided by 2, or in this case, 7 plus y sub 2 divided by 2. But we know this point must have coordinates negative 2, 2 because we're given the midpoint. So from here we can set up two equations, one to find x sub 2 and one to find y sub 2, which will give us the coordinates of point B. We know negative 5 plus x sub 2 divided by 2 must be equal to negative 2, and we also know 7 plus y sub 2 divided by 2 must be equal to positive 2. So let's first solve for x sub 2. So we have negative 5 plus x sub 2 divided by 2 equals negative 2. Let's go ahead and clear this fraction here by multiplying both sides of the equation by 2. So on the left side, 2 over 2 simplifies to 1. So we have negative 5 plus x sub 2 equals, on the right side, negative 4. We'll add 5 to both sides to solve for x sub 2. So we have x sub 2 equals negative 4 plus 5 is positive 1. So this will be the x coordinate of point B. And now to find y sub 2, or the y coordinate, we would have the equation 7 plus y sub 2 divided by 2 equals positive 2. And again, we'll clear this fraction by multiplying both sides by 2. Could put this over 1 if we want to. But either way, 2 over 2 simplifies to 1. So we have 7 plus y sub 2 equals 4. Subtract 7 on both sides. So we have y sub 2, or the y coordinate, is equal to 4 minus 7, which is equal to negative 3. So the coordinates of point B would be 1, negative 3. This would be the other endpoint of segment AB that has midpoint negative 2, 2. Let's go back and verify this by looking at our graph. Notice that point B, from the graph, does have an x coordinate of positive 1 and a y coordinate of negative 3, as we found algebraically. I hope you found this explanation helpful.